Tommy goes for a walk and does some bird watching. Tommy gets on his unicycle to go to work. Oh, he's got a car, but it hurts his teeth to drive. See, Tommy is a no-arm Chinese fellow. He lost both arms in a wood chipper incident. He was told, testing his blind obedience, he was told to stick his right arm into wood chipper. And so Tommy stuck his arm in wood chipper. And the left arm saw what was going on with the right arm and jumped off. It's a very wise thing to do if you are an arm. I am Melton, son of a carpenter and Mary. A handsome bald guy right there with the DVD and the big eye on his chest. Dad, a carpenter, worked on skyscrapers. Mom, Mary Ann. I am the son of a carpenter and Mary. I get to make parables, and this is my parable series about Tommy, the no-armed Chinese fellow. And of course, Tommy got a promotion out of sticking his arm in the wood chipper and losing the other arm. He's bossing a whole lot of folks around. And they've learned how to distract Tommy so they can goof off. So when Tommy gets to work, and he works for the Unseen Business Street, works all over the city he's in, L.A., works all over the place, doing one thing or another, and today he's working in the middle of downtown L.A. And they meet him there, and they hatch that plan to distract him. Oh, this is a bluer part there, looking a little darker blue. Is a new eye bigger than the old browner circles there that used to be all dark brown? It's genetic carpentry at work. Don't try this at home. I am the son of a carpenter. I get to do this. Yeah, I'm growing a new pair of eyes. See for yourself in this opportunity phone card, perhaps, imagery, my video parables, and yeah, come see me in person when you can't reach me by phone. 424-229-4140. Come see me in person and tell me what you think of those eyes, because, yeah, it's censorship, religious censorship. I'm here to build Jesus' immaculate mansion here on earth. That's my work, and it's more than just my graphic art livelihood and your livelihood as well. You can't reach a customer. You don't know how many other customers you can't reach. That's your gate's livelihood. Next time you get that phone ringing or the busy signal, whatever you get when you don't get me, and calling up another customer, realize that. Now, excuse me. Tommy's gotten to work. I realize that, and yeah, come see me in person. You want some beautiful artwork designed. Be in these Tommy parables. Be a part of build a better world. Jesus' immaculate house to be built worldwide. Inspire the future and present to greatness with those homes. But you gotta see me in person to do that because of religious censorship. I'm searching for disciples, well, just folks who can tell me what they think of our hijacked lifelines. Not one 9/11 flight 93 check in over 8 years of asking. No certified mail, no non-certified mail as well. 4260 Eagle Rock Boulevard, Apartment 409, Los Angeles, California, 90065. Make a video of your hijacked mail before you send it. It's going to be stolen. Same for your your calls. It takes just 5 minutes. Make the video with your phone, post it with your phone, be a part of the 4th of July wave retreat this year. It's next month. Of course, every day is 4th of July. Pick up that phone, document. Religious science except in America that can place someone named Hussein in the highest office in America. Just a few years after 9/11. Now let me finish this. I don't want to let it get too big. It's going to be a nice slideshow, just a matter of megabytes, but right now it's a video and it takes up a lot of space. Tommy's there and Jessica meets him there, one of his workers, and says, oh, he must have pretty good balance to ride around on that unicycle. And Tommy likes to brag as someone locks up his unicycle for him. He says, oh yeah, I have very good balance. I've always had very good balance. And King, his assistant for the moment, he says, well, could you walk around that building up there on the leads? And Tommy says, oh sure, could do that. And Mia plays along. She wants to goof off too. She says, show us. And Tommy kind of panned himself in the corner. He can't back down. He goes up to that 10th story there. And he starts walking around the building. Some of his workers are there. What the hell happened to it? Some of his workers are there. There's nothing in there. That's my worker. That's my Excel. It's very good. I didn't want an excuse to show you Excel. Some of his workers are urging him on from windows there, and others are doing that from the street below. Oh, it shows how the lids are getting wider as well. It's, yeah, the bigger, bluer surface need more room to see with the new lens, I guess. It goes that way, then get back to, I'm more like this right now. And it has about a few times. Has stretched this way. I think that's the way it's going to end up. Genetic carpenter, not just with the eyes, of course. Got to go on with the whole body. That's why I'm in a wheelchair. Got my motorized wheelchair today, so my arms aren't dead after a short distance. The muscle is being replaced, all that kind of stuff. Now back to my story. Tommy's out on the ledge, walking around that building. And he's having a good time. He's showing off, and it's easier for him to walk around on a thin ledge because he doesn't have those arms, to scrape up against the walls and stuff, side of the building. So he's also a thin Chinese guy. So he's showing off, and of course his workers they like it as well. And all of a sudden, a bird lands on his head. And he wants to shoo it away, but all he can do is just say shoo. He can't use his hands. And that kind of upsets him as he's walking around the building there. And he looks down and sees how far up he is. And that doesn't help at all. And he kind of just freezes against that building there, presses his back as well as he could. He'd have his arms against the building if he had them, but he's kind of frozen there, and he gets to the crowd gathers down below. And you know what some, especially in Los Angeles, what crowds are going to do, they start chanting, jump, jump, jump. And of course the cops show up. They got to act like they don't want him to jump. So they have the guy with the megaphone downstairs, and guys, you know, go quickly up the stairs, and they're looking out at him from the windows there, and they say, "Don't jump, you know, fella, don't jump. It's gonna be all right. I don't know what's wrong, but it's not worth it." Tommy, you can't much explain that. He's kind of dared to walk around the building. All you can do is just sit there with the bird on his head and now one on his shoulder, and try not to look down. The officer tells him not to look down. And looking up doesn't help him much either, so he tells him to just kind of just stay there. And closing his eyes doesn't really help at all. So they do their best. They got the net down below, and as they chant, "Jump, jump, jump," this guy in a wheelchair, handsome bald guy in a wheelchair, rose up through the crowd, and he asked the policeman there with the megaphone, "Can I have it?" And he says, "Tommy, don't jump. We need you. For decades, for descendants of descendants to witness." Yeah, Tommy Brown knows him, and he's right in the way of me building that Immaculate House. That Jesus' Immaculate House called an opportunity house you want. There will be a test at the end, especially for those deathless Buddhists. And yeah, I yell up at him, "Don't jump, don't jump. We need you." The guy closes to him, the cop closes and reaches out and just grabs his leg, and it upsets Tommy, and he kind of loses his balance. He falls off, but luckily that guy's got a good grip. He kind of bounces a few times on the side of the building. He's going to be bruised up a little bit when he goes home early, you know, to Rio. Well, actually, it'll be the next day or a few days. They have to, you know, watch him for a little while and make sure he was just up there on a dare, not thinking of anything. Come see me in Melton. I can put your, remember when you hear that siren, 424-229-4140, tell everyone it's your 4th of July party. Make a video of America's Hijack Lifelines. See that phone? It's every child in America's lifeline. Make the video of whatever you get when you don't get me. It's going to be boring, phone ringing, error message, busy signal. You get to leave a message. I sure don't get it. And you don't show up on my caller ID. So make the video, post the video, tell everyone at your 4th of July get together or any get together this weekend. 2, flight 93, check and post in 5. Say phone records don't lie when they are made to lie by dangerous folks hijacking our lifelines and altering phone records to hide that. We have Trump and Hussein's. Oh, that's not too clear. A phone gate. There's some nice flashlights. Make the video, post the video, tell everyone you know to do the same. Come see me, have wit, we'll travel, show me the perfect place to build Jesus' Immaculate House. We're what? And yeah, pick up those cameras, make those Sandra videos only you can make. Make these Tommy videos only you can make, and do that with your phone nowadays. I better end, it's getting too long. 14 minutes, that's way too long. Goodbye.